All right, the time is now. Gooey chocolate cake topped with silky smooth ganache. This decadent dessert is so delicious, you will not believe it's also quite good for you.
It smells good too. To work her magic is the healthy chef, Therese Cutter. Welcome, Teresa.
Hi, guys.
Oh my goodness, this looks so good. What makes it healthy?
It is amazing. I'll show you what makes it healthy. It's delicious and healthy. It's gluten-free too, so it's fantastic. Beautiful protein-rich and vitamin E-rich almonds. We've got cocoa powder here that's also rich in magnesium. And also, chocolate actually helps to raise serotonin levels. That makes you feel good too. So that'll make you feel good. We've got cocoa powder. Now, unrefined, we've got beautiful cold-pressed olive oil, extra virgin olive oil.
So rather than butter.
It's a one-bowl cake. We've got water. You've got half a cup of water here. Or you can use almond milk if you want. You can use honey or in nice pure maple syrup. So I've got some beautiful maple syrup and organic eggs. I've got about 4 organic eggs in there. The recipe's on the site as well, on the Sunrise site. A generous pinch of sea salt and a little bit of vanilla, just to make it taste good as well. And just a couple of spoonfuls of baking powder, and that's all you need. It's one of those one bowl types of cakes that you can just literally mix all together.
So think about this cake, you've sacrificed none of the fun things. Like, it's healthy, but it still meets all the litmus tests of a quality full strength cake.
It is, it's healthy and delicious, and it's so moist. And the secret to making this cake, so once you've mixed it, just undercook it, just ever so slightly.
The undercook.
Yeah, people.
So how do you know that you are undercooking it enough for it not to be too runny?
There's a fine line. You put your little skewer in, you put your knife in, and just a little bit stuck to there is great.
Right.
You know?
Okay. It's because it's going to keep cooking a bit.
Yes, and it's going to be gooey. Otherwise, people tend to overcook their cakes and then they dry out.
Yeah.
And that's, you know, it's all over.
There are a few. It is all over. A dry cake.
You may as well end it.
Why would you bother?
No, just slightly undercook it. And look, you just put it into one of these 20-centimetre springform.
So that instant cake.
Yeah, and do you think don't use a mix master? Actually, do it by hand.
Oh, I love doing it by hand. It's so, you know, you put the French music on or put some relaxing music on, and you know, because
will
you
it
feel
work
good,
if
it's going
to
work.
Listen to Italian music. Or does it have to be French?
It's got to be Italian.
It
was French,
heavy metal,
okay.
If you wish.
Yeah, well, there you go.
Oh, yeah, some Rage Against the Machine or something like that.
You have a different flavour, of course. Okay, and now the ganache.
Okay, you mentioned the secret to the proper ganache.
Firstly, can we behold the ganache? Let's just look at it here. Because there's a silkiness to the texture of this that will blow people's minds. Yeah. How have you achieved this?
It is amazing. Okay, the secret to making ganache is when you boil your cream or your coconut cream, which way you want to go, you boil it, you put your broken up chocolate. You've got to use a really good chocolate. I've used a good...
Yeah, don't scrimp.
No. This is good Lindt chocolate, right? So it's an 80% Lindt chocolate that I've put in through. So it's 1-to-1. So it's 100 grams of cream to a bar of chocolate, to 100 grams of chocolate. You let it sit. You don't mix it.
Oh.
You let it sit for around 3 minutes, and then the chocolate slowly relaxes and melts into the cream without you stirring. You don't stir.
Oh, wow. Because, 3 minutes of stagnation.
Yeah, because if you stir, it'll split.
What?
This is what we offer right here.
If you stir, it'll split the chocolate, it's all over.
Okay.
You know?
So it just happens naturally.
Yeah, wow. And then you give it a mix and then just let it sit at room temperature. You don't put it in the fridge or anything like that. Let it sit there overnight. So you make this the night before you need it.
Yeah.
And look at that, it's beautiful. Oh. It's silky and smooth. And if you wanted to make like chocolate truffles out of it, just put it in the fridge and set it and roll them into truffles. But this is fantastic. But like you said, Mon, if you wanted it dairy-free, you can use my avocado frosting. The recipe's on the side as well. Or you can use a lovely coconut cream.
It's also in your book.
It's also in my healthy baking book, which is 20% off today.
Oh, yay!
Which is fantastic.
Well, what more do you want?
Multi-purpose ganache. Is fantastic. Thank you so much, Teresa.
Thanks, guys.
We'll get a taste after the break. Can't wait.
Okay,
yes,
fantastic.
You can check out that recipe at sunrise.com.au. And also, as we said, Teresa's cookbook, Healthy Baking, out now, 20% off. We're really interested in...
We've gone a conservative
style. Yes, it's a word I've been saying, because they've been snaffling up cakes.
Straight into it.
It's so good.
I thought we were going to build some suspense.
For the end break. Teresa, meet up. The recipe is going to be on our website. Delicious.
Thank
you so much. It is so
That's
good.
A religious experience.
Yeah.
mayhem going on in the studio, Mon, because there's free cake and there's been a scramble.
They're a really supportive group, aren't they?
There's literally not a member of our crew left behind the cameras almost. We've only got a couple of very, very devout cameramen left. Everyone
you
else.
You two get a whole cake. It was very good too. Teresa Cutters, the healthy
the
chef.
The ganache.
Thanks for your good work, guys, as always.
Yeah, thanks for your hard work. Bye, everyone.
See you guys.